captains, honorary members of the Gold Demonstration Team are circling high overhead and are distinctly painted C-147 jump aircraft at an altitude of 6,500 feet. The jumpmaster is actually looking out the left door of the aircraft. His head is outside and the wind is a cold. Through a series of hand and arm signals, the jumpmaster relays head presence to the pilot, maneuvering the aircraft to a precise exit point for the jumper. Watch closely as he makes the nose of the aircraft, moves slightly left or right in response to the steering instructions. The aircraft has been slowed to a safe exit of 120 miles per hour. The same speed as a free-fall parachute at terminal velocity. Ladies and gentlemen, due to regular attention overhead, our aircraft is inbound for the first pass to day performance. The jumpers are out and the smoke is on. We now have members of the Golden Knights in Freefall, rapidly approaching speeds of 120 miles per hour. These jumpers fly together, contact has been made, and the 14-inch mahogany baton exchange. These jumpers now alter their body positions to form 120 miles per hour spiral in the sky, then separate and prepare to deploy their main parachute. There you have the high-flying black and gold of your United States Army parachute team, the Golden Knights. This is their Charlie Miller, former teammate of the Eagles aerobatics team and parachute manufacturer. Mr. Steve Schneider exchanged the first baton in 1958. It was then believed that two jumpers in Freefall could not possibly make contact. The parachutes used by the Golden Knights are flexible wing gliders, constructed of lightweight ripstop nylon. These parachutes have an inherent forward airspeed of 22 miles per hour. To turn left, the jumper pulls down on the left steering line. To turn right, the jumper simply pulls down on the right steering line. As these jumpers near ground, they will pull down on both steering lines simultaneously for the safe and softest possible landing. The smoke trail of these jumpers just left the sky, replaced by two M18 red smoke grenades, which emit a continuous stream of smoke for up to 90 seconds. The jumper attaches them to 1 foot using accessories on the ground, then ties the lander to the activated pin. By pulling on the lander, the jumper can ignite the smoke immediately upon exiting the aircraft, rolling in freefall, or even under canopy. Let's make some noise the second jumper breaks into the target area. For a beautiful, yes, better landing! Ladies and gentlemen, if you have ever wondered what would happen if a parachute did not work, then watch closely, because you are about to find out. Please watch as our next member demonstrates a dramatic cutaway maneuver. The same diversion of discipline, precision and teamwork exhibited by the demonstrators in Japan is also reflected in the Golden Knights of Elite Aviation Section. Nicknamed Team 6, the pilots who fly the team aircraft average 5,500 flying hours per aviator. The maintenance technicians, whose mission is to keep the aircraft flying, average 10 years military experience. Together, their expert teams result in the safest aircraft possible for the Golden Knights. The jumper is out as ignited as smoke as he glides to his opening point. This jumper is wearing three parachutes instead of the two that we normally wear. He will open his first parachute much higher than normal and intentionally cause it to malfunction. Please do not be alarmed as his first parachute begins to scream. There's absolutely no danger to this jumper. This is our only solo maneuver, yet one of our most exciting. This jumper has just released one side of his parachute
at an accelerating reference speed in excess of 90 miles per hour. It would be impossible for these members to fly away in their disappearance. So we must roll into complete, return the freefall, and open his main parachute. And there you have the high-flying black and golden door. He's not actually a Army parachute team, the Golden Knights.
The reserve or auxiliary parachutes used by the Golden Knights are also flexible wing gliders, such as the one you see now. However, there are some differences. They are white in color, with a slightly smaller wing surface area and a much greater forward airspeed of up to 30 miles per hour. This enables our gunners to make attack in any type of situation, such as a downtown intersection or major league stadium. While each of the jumpers will pack his or her own main parachute, a certified parachute technician must repack a reserve every 180 days, whether it's used or not. The released parachute you see floating earthward will be recovered, untangled, and hooked up to use again. If it does float towards you, please do not attempt to catch a retreat. Our recovery team is on the way. The C-147 jump aircraft used by the Golden Knights is a medium-range, twin-turbo-drive passenger plane, modified for jump use. It has one large door on the rear of the aircraft, which can be opened in flight. It is pressurized and comfortable to travel from Fort Bragg, North Carolina, to various locations throughout the country. Its civilian counterpart, the Dash 8, is produced by Bombardier of Canada. The Golden Knights 2C-147 are the only two in existence within the Army's inventory. Now, ladies and gentlemen, you will experience the excitement of the Golden Knights hyperboarding canopy. As the aircraft crosses overhead, the jump mask gives the cross arm signal of hot fire, signifying that the airspace is clear and then they can jump. The jumpers complete their final gear shift and move to the door in the rear of the aircraft. A thumbs up signal is then given. Watch momentarily for two jumpers to exit the aircraft. These jumpers are flying parachutes much smaller than our actors in hand, with an average square footage of 92 square feet. They are capable of speeds in excess of 90 miles per hour in the sky. These jumpers are going to show you the full flight characteristics of our ramp air parachutes. Please do not be alarmed if they come in at a high rate of speed. Unlike the military jet, the United States Army Parachute Team is comprised mostly of non-commissioned officers. The 89 men and women of the Golden Knights come from various jobs throughout the Army to serve 3 years on one of the 5 major sections of the team. The Administrative Support Section contains the Office of Command, Operations, Parachute Maintenance, Logistics, and Media Relations. Our Aviation Section flies and maintains our 2 C-147 jump aircraft and 3 UV-18 Viking twin arms. Our competition section is comprised of our 4-way and 8-way freefall formation team. Our tandem section provides tandem parachute jumps to select VIPs. And finally, our demonstration section. Because the Army's colors are black and gold, so is our team. Performing for you today is the Gold Demonstration Team. Since inception, the team has performed in all 50 states, 48 foreign nations, has produced hundreds of world champions, and over 100 national champions.
If you notice these small parachutes overhead, they will perform on a drumhead wing tug, where they bring their panicking almost to stop in the air. There's the boat. We will pull down on the front part of the carriage, and spiral it down, at speeds at over 90 miles per hour, then execute a 270-degree turn, keep it plating out across the ground, and prepare for a beautiful stand-up landing. Let's make some noise for these little jumpers. Ladies and gentlemen, we always enjoy our training pictures. So if you are on Instagram, all the pictures that you take today, please tag us at Army Golden Knights and at GK Gold Team. If you tag GK Gold Team, please use the hashtag Gold Team Best Team.
Right now.
If you look closely at these rubber frames in the car area, you may notice the scratches connected. Each year, the Golden Knights head south of the winter for winter training at Homestead, Florida. Burdened by thousands of cumulative freefall parachute jumpers, our X team prepared each jumper for everything from high speed maneuvers to mass formation, and from night operations to panic piloting. These jumpers are executed at down climbing and are accelerating earthward speeds in excess of 60 miles per hour. You may be able to hear them as they say, ready up. At 1,000 feet, they're doing a wind penetration check, a downwind lane, a base lane, and then turning the wind on final approach. You may hear ready brakes. Let's make some noise for these three jumper cranes in the park area. Become a Golden Knight. Each individual must earn at least 100 freefall parachute jumps, be enlisted in the Army, and have a clean civilian and military record.
And don the distinctive maroon beret of today's modern parachute. I would like to introduce them. But first, performing the difficult duties of ground control, from Harrisonburg, Virginia, he's an airborne infantryman with 850 free fall parachute jumps, Sergeant Mark Pierce. And now for the jumpers. From Orange, California, he's an airborne infantryman with 900 freefall parachute jumps, Sergeant First Class Ty Kettenhoffen. From Weiden, Germany, he's an airborne satellite systems operator with 2,166 freefall parachute jumps, Staff Sergeant Dominic Perry. From Montezuma, Iowa, he's an airborne nurse with 1,032 free fall parachute jumps, Sergeant Skyler Romberg. From Rayford, North Carolina, he's an airborne infantryman with 1,826 free fall parachute jumps, Staff Sergeant Morgan George. From sunny Miami, Florida, he's an airborne ranger with 2,862 free fall parachute jumps, Staff Sergeant Dan Gerlach. From Houston, Texas, he's an airborne parachute maintenance technician with 1,871 free fall parachute jumps, Sergeant First Class Jesse Robbins. From Vernon, Connecticut, he's an airborne infantryman with 2,612 free fall parachute jumps, Staff Sergeant Luke Ulf. And leading the Golden Knights in freefall on his 1,000th freefall parachute jump. From Walkerton, Indiana, he's an airborne explosive ordnance disposal technician with 1,000 freefall parachute jumps, Sergeant First Class Corey Rush. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to present to you the Gold Demonstration Team for the 2021 Airshow season. All members of your United States Army Parachute Team, the Golden Knights. Now, in keeping with a long-standing Golden Knight tradition, we would like to present today's baton, which has been flown in freefall, to a distinguished member of today's audience. Miss Beth Smithson has stepped forward and been introduced to the team leader. She will meet each of the individual team members. As the granddaughter of a World War II veteran, Beth's love of country and family runs deep. She's been involved in the Millville Air Show since the first show in 1991. Beth proudly serves on the Air Show Committee and has helped coordinate various logistics for this and previous Air Show events. She also supports the Millville Army Airfield Museum. and other events throughout the year. Outside of the air show, Beth can be seen working in the FBO or out on the ramp talking with customers and flight school students here at the airport. Beth Smithson, the United States Army, the Golden Knights, and the great state of New Jersey proudly salute you. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our performance for the day, and on behalf of the entire team, I would like to thank each and every one of you for being such a warm and receptive airborne audience. In closing, I leave you with this final thought. In the future, may all of your days be prosperous, and your nights golden.
Let's check it out. The staff, Sergeant Deputies, and the Golden Knights, to say good night. Great job, as usual, out there, guys.